this is the system really that starts us making worlds.
Surrounded by toys, but making a state-of-the-art video game is a serious business. We're inside Naughty Dog, one of the world's leading games creators, to take a look at their latest slice of PlayStation perfection, Jak and Daxter, the precursor legacy.
We loved the adventure games of the past, the Zeldas, and we wanted to incorporate some of the adventuring style into the action of a Crash Bandicoot game, of a Spyro game, or of a Mario game. So we really wanted to take all of those games and combine them together and do something new and different. The hero of the story is Jak. He's got a destiny that will be revealed, maybe even not in this game, but sometime in the future. On top of that, Daxter, the sidekick to the main character, has turned himself, by falling into a vat of dark eco, into a little fuzzy creature.
Jak was the cornerstone of the design for Jak and Daxter. You can see that he has a lot of striking features, one of which is his flamboyant hair, almost very flame-like, and the big ears. If you were to look at Jak for only a few seconds, hopefully the thing you should walk away from is the vibrant colors and the large ears. You recognize that guy from the lineup. The emphasis of character design for this product is because of the power of the PlayStation. We have so much more information that we can put into these characters, we have to emphasize the production design from day one.
Daxter is not a character that you can actually control, and that was very important to us. The idea is that you are Jak, and you should feel that you're playing as Jak. That's why Jak doesn't say much. Daxter is not you. He may crack a joke that you don't think is funny. He may tell you to do something that you can't really tell yourself where to go because you wouldn't know.
Don't step into the light, Jak! Don't step into the light!
So the idea is that Daxter is the funny sidekick and that you are Jak. This is very similar to a Disney movie setup, if you think about it, with the genie, who is not the main character that has all the wisecracks, but Aladdin is a very quiet character. He doesn't have very, very strong personality. He has a personality, but not a strong one.
So what we have here is Billy taking the a typical model, in this case, Kira, one of our main characters. And Billy takes the schematic drawing that we saw from before. We bring it into the computer, and now it's his responsibility to take that schematic and turn it into a 3D model.
Rule number one, I don't date animals.
Naughty Dog came into this project with about 15 people. We are now 35.
So what can gamers expect for the European versions of Jak and Daxter?
We've always made a really good localization. We would go and actually lip sync in past games. We also make sure that the PAL version is full screen. We make sure that it's running at the correct speed, that the characters have the right moves, that everything works as if we had made it as a PAL version first. And absolutely, positively, we're going to do it again.
One of the things that has been very time consuming for us is to actually create these immense worlds with these vistas. We really wanted to make a lush, detailed, organic kind of fantasy world and fantasy characters.
I can't seem to catch a single fish in this river.
That would draw a wide audience of players.
We said, okay, this is it. We're finally going for it. It's going to be one big, seamless, load-free world. You'll be able to go from the beginning to the end without stopping and see from wherever you've been to wherever you're going. PlayStation 2 made that possible.
There's a number of big difficulties in making a single large world. I mean, one is just the sheer construction challenge, and then there's the technical challenges of actually juggling it all through the PlayStation so that it works. Here we have Jordan and Greg. These people have come from Disney feature animation. So what are you guys doing here? You seem to be having a lot of fun.
Since they're so far apart, Daxter's got to get onto Jack's shoulder
right
somehow. So we were talking about
cheating.
Ruben's talent here has been to give us the facial expressions of the characters.
We want basic bonum shapes and different eye shapes, and make a blend in between to get what we want.
That's another example of how the PlayStation 2 has allowed us to have all these features, which are the same exact technology that goes into feature animation.
With action, adventure, fantasy, a great story, huge worlds, and groundbreaking animation and technology, Jack and Daxter, the precursor legacy, is set to play a leading role in redefining the future of gaming.
Naughty Dog's focus is making something that drives people absolutely crazy. They love playing.